The next question.
Minister, the Dún Laoghaire Harbour Company is a quango that has failed and should be dissolved forthwith. Its 18-year history is 18 years of jobs for the boys at the top, lavish salaries, lavish expenses, who've run the harbour into the ground. We've had another nail in the coffin now with Stena being withdrawn. So I'm asking, Minister, can we simply dissolve Dún Laoghaire Harbour Company and put it back under direct council control, where the people of Dún Laoghaire can have some say about how we can save the harbour as an amenity and a working harbour?
Thank you, Minister.
Thank you, Deputy. I am very clear that the future of Dún Laoghaire Harbour is best placed within a local authority-led governance structure, as is set out in the National Ports Policy. My officials are currently finalising the text of the Harbours Amendment Bill of 2015. The bill will provide the legal basis for the transfer by ministerial order of the 5 designated ports of regional significance, which are Drogheda, Dún Laoghaire, Galway, New Ross and Wicklow. I expect shortly to see government approval for this bill and to commence passage through the Oireachtas. The bill is designed to provide maximum legislative flexibility and will allow for either a transfer to the local authority of the ministerial shareholding in a particular company, or a transfer of all assets, liabilities and employees of the port company to the local authority, and the dissolution of that company's corporate structure. Ahead of the bill's enactment, Dún Laoghaire Rathdown County Council will carry out a full due diligence of the harbour company. I look forward to the completion of that process and receipt of its finding and the Council's perspective thereafter. Obviously, the optimal manner of transfer is one which finds broad-based consensus and agreement between all parties, and I am committed, Deputy, to working with both the company and the council to ensure the sustainable future of the harbour.
Come out, Deputy Richard.
I've been
Weber.
Asking about this issue for the last 4 or 5 years. Now, I'm very glad that we're moving the harbour company back under council control. It's something we've been calling for in Dún Laoghaire for a long time. But the issue that was left hanging by Minister Varadkar was whether it would be a corporate subsidiary or whether it would be directly under the council. And Minister Varadkar said he favoured it being a corporate subsidiary. Now, what I want is clarity and, frankly, a commitment that it will not be a corporate subsidiary, that essentially the wasteful jobs for the boys, management structure, administration, excessive fees, excessive salaries, masses amounts of money waste on master plans that never came to fruition, on waste at every level while the harbour itself has been running to the ground and the actual frontline staff have been reduced to negligible numbers. It's been a failure and we need to bring it. I mean, just to give you some idea, right? This harbour company has 20 employees left and the CEO is getting €136,000 a year, gets £12,000 on top of that in fees for going to nine meetings a year.
Thank
and
you.
Gets £10,000 extra in expenses for reasons unknown. He used to get £20,000 until we kicked up about it. He in an answer to a question about another €20,000 he paid to himself, he said he had paid that in lieu of holidays, which you're not allowed to do.
Thank
Minister
you.
Varadkar said that was unacceptable. We still haven't got an explanation of it. There's been millions wasted on master plans that have never come to fruition, right? It's a complete honeypot that has been milked by these executives and directors' fees and so on while the harbour's been running to the ground.
Thank you, Deputy.
So I'm asking,
can we
bring it fully back under council
Minister?
And get rid of this
structure? Deputy, let me emphasise again that I am very clear that the appropriate location for a port of this scale and location is inside a local authority. And in this case it is, as you're aware, Dún Laoghaire Rathdown. I am well aware of the challenges that the port faces in relation to its sustainability in the future, due in no small part to the decision of Stena Sealing to consolidate its services within Dublin Port. I believe it is necessary that issues in relation to the development of that harbour be handled in the context of it residing within the local authority, and I will be making a decision soon regarding the method within which that will happen. What I need to do alongside that is bring in the piece of legislation that will give statutory footing to the harbour policy, as I've outlined earlier, and I'm aiming to get government agreement to do that very soon.
Thank you. Deputy Richard Boyd Barrett.
And what I'm asking, Minister, that in achieving that, we don't have a CEO of a company with 20 people who's paying himself about $150,000 included expenses a year, or other executives are paying themselves about $100,000 each euro a year, or chairpersons and directors who between them over the last 10 years have taken about $100,000 to $140,000 in expenses, and you can go on through the list, millions wasted on consultants' plans, when the actual harbour is an amenity and as a working harbour has been run into the ground. This wasteful, executive, parasitical management and board structure must be dissolved, and dissolved fully. You could save about €600,000 a year if you did that, and that could be actually put in to employing people to do real things in the harbour and actually develop the harbour as a public amenity and a working harbour, which these people have singularly failed to do.
Thank you. Minister, to conclude.
In order for me to first make a decision regarding the manner in which this port will be integrated into the local authority, what I need to do first is bring in the legislation which will create the framework inside which those decisions will be made. I will be doing that. I'll be gaining government agreement to the heads of the bill, and we'll be introducing the legislation shortly afterwards. And then, as I have said, when that is in place, I will then make a decision regarding how that integration will best happen. The objective that I have is to come up with a way in which that port can have a secure and sustainable future. And I'm very much aware that some of the recent decisions that have been made, in fact, particularly the decision that has been made by Stenis Sealing, does have very severe consequences for that port.
Thank you.
And I believe that is best handled inside the local authority.
Margaret.